about data is, to me, not to him. I think this is the first time that something like this has been made. You know, it's very difficult for me to come up with a general rule regarding how to do it. It depends very much on the specificity of the market. I don't know, I never thought about the general rule, how to share and how, when to not share. Clearly, in some situations, the word sharing is good, in others, it's not. So, I don't have any general rule for this. I think sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not. I think that what was said before, that every time we have a situation that we need to analyze, this is part of at least the tradition of most economists, I don't know, I cannot say for, it's to have an analysis based on the market specific structure, behavior, the way that it engaged the competition. So there are many papers about information sharing in markets, and sometimes I usually don't like to talk about in situations like this about my own papers, but a recent paper from last year that I had about information sharing in auctions. Point out that it affects the outcome of the auction in a way that is quite complicated. It's a paper with John Asker and Arvid Pekes, and in a way that it affects the dynamics of the market. This is paper about dynamics, and sometimes it may be positive, and sometimes maybe negative to the outcome of the market. And clearly, we can generate examples that show that sometimes it's positive and sometimes it's negative. So I don't know about the general rule. It very much depends on the details of the competition. The issue is that when you analyze the market, the way that the prices are determined, the way that the firms need to put an auction or to do something else, all these details will determine the market equilibrium. And sometimes information sharing will be good, and sometimes it will be bad. So I don't think me as an economist can come up with a general rule what to do. And that's part of the problem in the discussion between economists and lawyers. I don't have any general rules for this. You need general rules that I don't have. I cannot supply.
Well, I would just add, I basically agree. One minute. It's really a question of standardization. Is it good or bad? We can deter changes in an industry or promote competition. But there are a lot of examples. This isn't a new question. Think about insurance in the United States. ISO used to pool insurance information, and one company would pull out if it thought it was contributing more than it was getting back because it was the biggest one. Same with some of these scanner data should be made available to the industry. Well, if I'm the biggest guy in the industry, maybe I get a competitive advantage by not sharing my data. But maybe I invest in getting data that I don't want to share with anybody. So it's not so obvious. Now, there are several industry associations, like multi-listing services for real estate, in which they collect ventures that share data. And once they do that, they have obligations to let new people in order to not be subject to the antitrust laws. That sometimes works pretty well. But again, I think it's going to depend on the incentive to invest, get the data, the innovative uses of the data versus promoting competition. So I agree with Chaim. Unfortunately, there are no easy answers, just like in the general case of do I want standards in an industry that's dynamically changing or not. It can be sometimes good and sometimes bad.
Thank you.